What's up, guys? Welcome to the channel. My name is Evans. Adobe has just released the 2022 update for Lightroom Classic. And in this video, I just want to take a look at two of the main features that I like so much about this upgrade and talk about them. So let's jump into Lightroom right away and take a look at these two new features. Okay, so here we are in Lightroom and I have this image loaded right here. The first thing I want to show you guys is the new select subject tool. So the select subject tool, it's very interesting. So there is two parts to it. There's a select subject and there is the select sky. I'm going to show you both of them. Let's start off with the select subject tool. Now, if you look up here, you can see that the interface has changed a little bit. Whereas we used to have the old adjustment tools up here, now you have this particular masking tool right here. And if you click on the masking tool, you have this dialog box that opens, and right at the top you have the first one being select subject. So let's take a look and see what that does. Once you click on it, it's going to say detecting subject. Give it a few seconds to detect the subject, and as you can see, it selected the subject and highlighted the subject in this red overlay. So now what can you do with this selection? But first of all, let's take a look at how much control we have. With the new masking tools, we have the option to combine different tools or different adjustment tools to create the mask. So I have this subject selected, but as you can see down in the bottom here, it selected more than the subject. So if I want to get rid of that, I can now combine the brush tool with the subject selection tool and refine this mask in that way. I'm going to do subtract and I'm going to select brush, and I can increase the size of my brush or decrease it and just paint away the extra selection right here that I don't want on the subject. Right? And you can see it's done the mask for the subject. And it's also done the mask for the brush. So I can turn off, right, or preview the brush that I just did. And this is the subject. And it seems to have put in them on this sort of like mask layers, for lack of a better word. And you can now make your adjustments that you want to make to the subject. I'm going to hide the overlay. And let's say I want to brighten out the subject a little bit, maybe make the subject pop a little bit. I can bring out the shadows a little bit, maybe add a little bit more highlights to the subject, and I'm done with this, right? The next thing I want to do is maybe the background. I want to darken the background a little bit. So what I'm going to do now is to go up here, create a new mask. I'm going to do select subject again. And once the subject is selected, I am now going to this time use invert. So I'm going to invert the selection. And so now the background is selected and the subject is not. And so if I want to darken that background a little bit, I can now turn off the shadows just to make it easier for me to see what I'm doing. Turn off the overlay so it makes it easier for me to see what I'm doing. And I can now begin to work on the background. I'm going to bring in the shadows just a little bit. I am going to bring down the exposure just a little bit, right? And right there and then, if this is what you were aiming for, you would have achieved that. But this is just to show you guys how much more control and how easy it is to now make selections right within Lightroom Classic. And so with that done, if I want to maybe, soften the background a little bit, I can use my texture slider to do that. Right, just soften out the background a little bit, and you can see how things go from here. You can play around with this and do a lot with that. So the next thing that I want to show you guys is the select sky tool. So in that, I'm going to open up this new image, and with this image open, I want to maybe select just the sky, right? Or I just want to make some changes to maybe the foreground. I'm going to start off by making a quick selection, an automatic selection tool using the sky select tool. So select sky. It's going to try to detect the sky. And as you can see, it's detected the sky up here. And there we go. It's made a selection of the sky. And if I want to make any adjustments to the sky, then yes, I can go ahead. I'm going to turn off the overlay. I'm going to maybe just bring out the shadows a little bit in the sky, bring it down the, you know, the blacks a little bit, not too much there. I don't really want to make any changes to this image, but just for the purpose of demonstration. Now, I want to make a little bit of an adjustment to the foreground. So let's make some selections in the foreground. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new mask, and I'm going to use the sky select tool again. And now, once the sky is selected, I'm going to come down here and invert that as well. And with the inverted sky, I really want to just make just maybe a tiny adjustment to just this bottom half of the foreground. And so I can now add on new tools to refine this mask. So to refine the mask, I'm going to do a subtract again. And I'm going to use the brush tool. And this time I'm going to maybe pick a bigger brush. But because we use that subtract tool, you can see that the brush has the minus in the middle. And I can paint out these areas here roughly. Right, and with that, we have limited our selection to just the immediate foreground. And if I turn off the overlay, if I want to make any adjustments to just that portion of the image, I can now begin to do that, right? So I can bring the shadows down a little bit if I want to, right? And play around with that section just a little bit. And so just with that, this is what we have done from that to that, right? Before and then after. And this is now to show you guys how easy it is to make selections right here within Lightroom. So before, I would probably take some of these complex selections into Photoshop, but now you can do a lot more within Lightroom with these new masking tool and combining the different adjustments tools to make and refine your mask to however you want it to be. All right, guys, so that's it for this video. This is just a quick introduction to the new masking tool in Lightroom Classic. In future videos, you may take a look, a deep dive into how to use this practically when editing your images. All right, stay blessed, keep creating, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. God bless.